I'm in a movie, Mary Shelley, which is out soon-ish. I can't say exactly when, but I think towards the end of this year, with Elle Fanning playing the lead of Mary Shelley and Belle Powley and Douglas Booth playing the other two leads. And they're fantastic. So I'm very much looking forward to seeing that. And then in September, I have Liar coming out, which is a six-part thriller for ITV and Sundance TV in the States. And it's me and Joanne Griffith. And it's written by Jack and Harry Williams, who wrote The Missing. So you can expect high drama with that one.
Talking about Liar, can you tell us a little bit more about your character, if you can, what the show's generally about?
Yeah, so my character and Joanne's character meet through a mutual contact, I guess. And we go out on a date together, and sort of situations arise during that night, and we have very differing views of what happened during the evening. So it then becomes about who's lying, who's telling the truth. And also all the we have fantastic cast for the whole show, in the whole show, and each character has a secret, a lie, something that they're hiding, something that they're covering up. So it becomes a big conspiracy, really. It's really exciting. It's a really exciting thriller. I'm super proud of it, and I'm really excited for people to see it.
Bring back to Mary Shelley, my final question before we let you go. Can you talk a little bit about why that project excited you and what it was like working with Belle and Elle?
Oh, I loved working with the guys. Honestly, I did about 10 days on the shoot in Luxembourg, and the guys have been filming for 2 weeks, so it's always a bit nerve-wracking going in, and everyone already knows each other, and you're not sure how you're going to fit in. But literally within a day, I was just having a ball, and they're such a talented bunch. Such a pleasure to work with them all, and we just had the best time. I loved it. I can't wait to see the finished result, because I think they're all going to absolutely sparkle.